So that's a great question, Dog, because the opening part of the book is China hacking Taiwan, and that happens every day. And part of the reason that I put that in the book is I'm a huge advocate of Taiwan, and I have a lot of friends, family, people that I've known that live there, and so that really raised a lot of eyebrows with the publisher because, like, are you sure you want to do this? You're going to piss somebody off. I said, well, when do you not piss people off in this world, right? And so I think when if the Chinese government reads my book, I think that they'll be a little bit offended, but also at the same time, the person behind the hack on the Chinese side is a general who's very rogue. And he's going off of the narrative, hey, I'm trying to take down Taiwan, leave me alone. And everybody kind of leaves him alone. They don't give a crap what he's doing until later in the book when they realize, going, wait a minute, the World Bank just shut off our funding because you're doing something. What did you do? So they actually turn against him at the end of the book. So it does have a lead in a little bit, but reality though is China does hack Taiwan every day of the week. That's not even fiction. That's a nonfiction reality. And then the fact that now that we found that China has been hacking underwater fiber cables, all that is real. So I'm not like creating some story that makes them look bad. It sort of just takes a real world reality and just makes a little fiction of it.
Right. On the geopolitical outlook of this stuff, are you an optimist for Taiwan